that all the work we do up here, we'll take a picture of it and we're going to put it onto a PowerPoint presentation for you to see if you don't get it. This will all be on one central document. We'll have a listening link there. And this is going to be sort of our learning block. Thank you, Mr. Goodman, for the idea. And all of them will be dated and you just have a link to it. And if you need help, you can just see the picture of all our solutions that we've done up here.
Hello, and in our new video, we're going to be talking about volume. Volume is the space enclosed inside a shape. So if I got, for example, this box, this is a three-dimensional shape because you can see the length, the width, and also the height of the object. Any space inside this box is the volume. There is actually a formula for volume, but this is only applied to regular prism. For example, this shape here, this loaf of bread here, which I'll go on to next, is a regular shape because wherever I cut it, the front face or the cross-sectional area will always be the same. Likewise, for example, like a cuboid, if I chop up the cuboid and in at regular intervals, the front face will always be the same size, the same shape, the same area. We have a formula here, and it's called volume equals cross-sectional area times length. Like I said, we have a loaf of bread here. The best analogy to use for volume is to think of you having a loaf of bread. The loaf of bread always has the same face, the same front. If it has the same front, it will have the same cross-sectional area. Cross-sectional area is actually the area enclosed by the face. So I'm just going to fill this in. So this is the cross-sectional area, that's illustrated. This will be the cross-section. The thing is, though, that's the cross-section. But the length here actually means that that wherever you cut this loaf of bread is that you will always find the same cross-section. So you chop up the bread, you have like different slices, and these different slices have the same shape. That principle will let you find the volume of this prism. It's a prism because it's three-dimensional. There is space inside this loaf of bread, and that will give us the volumes. You know that the volume is cross-sectional area times length. You have the cross-sectional area here, 30 centimeters square, that's given to you. The length of the bread itself is given to be 5 centimeters. So what do? You get 30 centimeters square, and you multiply it by 5 centimeters. The unit of volume, however, is centimetres cubed. Centimetre times centimetre, which is centimetre squared times centimetre and centimetre cubed. Now you know that the 30 times 5 is 150. In this case, this will be 150 centimetre cubed. The units are very important, regardless of whether it's an exam or not. If you just say 150, people won't know what you're talking about. You could be talking about the area, if you don't define it. So you have to define it as a centimetre cube. That's very important in whichever case it matters. However, if I had the units to be metres, then it would be metre cube. You know, kilometre, very good, nothing, kilometre cube. Kilometre squared, kilometre will be kilometre cube. If the units, however, were different, for example, if I had something different, let's say 1 meter here, this time that was 1 meter of a loaf of bread. What I'd have to do is I'd have to convert this unit here. You can't multiply these together because they're different units. Centimeters and meters are not the same. So you'll have to change this to centimeters. You know that in 1 meter there is 100 centimeters. So you can change that to 1 centimeter. Many people fall out on this and they forget that the units have to actually be the same for any formula to work. They have to correspond. I'll give you another example here. We'll let you stop this video just to think about it. If I have a cuboid here, just like the one I picked up here earlier, if you can say, and I said that this was 5 centimetres across length, 4 centimetres across age, and 3 centimetres across the width, what would be the volume? I'm just going to let you think, and I'm going to ask you to think, but what is the cross-sectional area? Now, I'm assuming you've already thought what the cross-sectional area is. You've only been given the measurements length, width, and height, but you haven't been. You don't know what the area is. The best way to tackle this is to go through this area here, the front face. We know that the area can be given by length times width, like in a rectangle. So let the area of the cross-sectional area of this prism is 5 times 4 centimeters. So I'm going to write centimeters here. It can be any unit as long as they're all the same. So this is 5 times 4. 5 times 4 equal to 20 centimeters squared. Remember, square is saying it's an area. Then you have the width. You have the length of this prism. Again, you do the same formula. I'm just going to write here underneath. You have 20 centimeters squared. You have a 3 centimeter length. And that totals 60 centimeters cubed. So this prism here encloses a volume inside it which is measurable to 60 centimeters cubed. A bit more challenging. This time you don't have a rectangle or given area. You have to calculate this area yourself. But it's a triangle this time. A triangle you can't do length times width because it doesn't make sense. But what you might remember from your studies is that the area of a triangle is a half multiplied by the base multiplied by the perpendicular height. You know it's perpendicular because if I make this more clear, there is actually square here, showing that the triangle has a 90 degrees. Now, I said that the length is 10, the length of the triangle is 10, the perpendicular height of the triangle, that's from here to here, is 3 centimeters. So you can actually calculate this cross section of area here very easily. 10 centimeters times 3 centimeters. Base times height, a half it. 10 times 3 is 30 centimeters squared, but because you're looking at a triangle, you're looking at half the area of a rectangle, so you'll do 10 times 3, which is 30, half that, which is 15 centimeters squared. Now you already know the length, which is 2 centimeters, so you apply 15 centimeters squared here, I'm just going to write it here now. 15 centimeters squared multiplied by the 2 centimeter length, and that totals 30 centimeters. In all questions, you have to remember there is a cross sectional area and also a length. Sometimes I might ask you to rearrange it, sometimes I might ask you if there is a cross sectional area, given that you know the volume and the length. Well, you have to remember though that this formula does not apply for shapes such as cones, because cones are irregular in the cross section. Because if you look at a cone, I'm just going to quickly try to draw one. This would be a cone. There. Now, if I cut up the cone into different sections, you have this section, then it gets smaller, and then it gets smaller. So you have three different sections. But the cross-sectional area, if you look from the bottom, will just get smaller. If you look at a cone from the base, you start off with a circle. So, you have a circle, a circle, and a circle. Get smaller. These cross-sectional areas are not equal, so you cannot apply this formula. In the next video, we'll explain how to do this. But right now, it's only for regular shapes. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Please hit the like button, subscribe, and could you please comment down below to let us know which topics you would like us to cover next. It really helps.